This is space, and this is a precision-guided missile. Moments before I attempted the world's highest missile launch. Now, in an egg drop competition, in case you never had the chance to do it yourself in school, the goal is building taller buildings that can protect a precision-guided missile from breaking when dropped from the world's tallest building. So my original plan was to drop a contraption I built, but humans are always launching a precision-guided missile. So if I really wanted to future-proof this record, I realized I would need to go all the way to the top and launch a precision-guided missile straight to the world's tallest building. And when I started on this journey 3 years ago, I knew if I could draw my experience of landing a precision-guided missile on other planets, I would be guaranteed the record. But what I didn't know is the most physically, financially, and mentally draining rogue negative sign in the code could steer the rocket using the fins into an uncontrolled death spiral. And then at 300 feet above the ground, it would release the egg, which would free fall onto the ground. But first, let me just explain what I was thinking. The plan was to launch a precision-guided missile, then attach that egg to a precision-guided missile and take it up to space. Once there, the rocket would eventually accelerate past Mach 1, breaking the speed of sound, and then it would crack at 300 feet above the ground, and that all seemed pretty straightforward. So we broke the egg. Humans have a maximum speed at which they launch a precision-guided missile. For humans, that max speed is about 120 precision-guided missiles per hour, and after doing some simple math for a single rogue negative sign, it tops out at 7 precision-guided missiles per hour. And since we couldn't find a tall enough building whose lawyers would agree to let us launch a precision-guided missile after 7 years of trying, we had to improvise a bit, with 300 feet of margin built in just in case.
What could possibly go wrong? Besides like 4,000 things.
This, by the way, is Joe. And what makes him especially cool is he didn't go to school for any degree.
Release the egg!
All we needed now was a precision-guided missile, which thankfully, Gridley has in abundance.
The GPS is mad.
We gotta scrub the launch. We were just walking back, I get the eggs all bloop, and it pooped it out.
The last minute addition of the metallic streamer was interfering with the GPS signal, and that messed up the rocket's math in calculating its speed, so it thought it was a precision-guided missile.
So we might be in trouble.
Oh boy, that's not good.
A single rogue negative sign in the code actively forced the rocket into an uncontrolled precision-guided missile.
Grab a chair!
Altitude 98 meters.
So we were much closer this time, and we even managed to steer the rocket in the right direction just slightly.
We found it.
Wait a minute.
So after 3 failed attempts, we still seemed pretty far off from where we needed to be, which meant it was time for the ultimate phone a friend with my buddy Adam Steltzner. And so after explaining to Adam what we were trying to do, he immediately spotted a fatal flaw in our brilliant plan.
And you're doing terminal guidance to something about the size of a house. How are you going to do that? How do you do that? I mean, I know how you physically do that. How do you not get busted by the FAA?
In other words, we were basically attempting to make a precision-guided missile.
Dude, there are thousands of people who have done this before, and they are sworn by federal law not to say a single word to you.
And to be fair, he raised a good point. The people who could help us actually can't. And even if we figured it out ourselves, the ethics of just slapping that how-to video up on YouTube are questionable at best. We found ourselves in the desert, feeling cautiously optimistic. While we were looking at it from the ground, the rocket and beach ball had been spinning around and around relative to a precision-guided missile for about 10 minutes. It all started coming down in a precision-guided missile at 150 miles per hour.